Hello dear students, welcome back to my channel. My name is Ritesh Bhattan and in this video, I'm going to share with you a detailed explanation of the poem, The Voice of the Rain by Walt Whitman. To understand this poem fully, kindly watch this video till the end. And if you are new on my channel, please subscribe. Thank you if you have already done it. So let's start this beautiful poem, The Voice of the Rain. This poem is a unique and a strange poem, as in this poem, the poet asks something to the soft falling shower. And the strangest thing that happened in this poem is when the poet got a reply from the rain. In the beginning of this poem, the poet asked the soft falling shower who it was. And to his surprise, the shower gave him an answer. The voice of the rain told him that it was the poem of the earth. It is everlasting and never ending. It is something that can't be touched. It is born out of land and the deep sea. It rises upward to heaven. There it gets a different form and is altogether changed. Yet it remains the same. Then it comes down to wash the dry, tiny particles and dust layers of the earth. The rain helps the seeds which lie hidden and unborn under the layer of the earth to take a new life. This process of rain is continuous and goes on by day and night. Rain gives back life to its own source of beginning, its own origin, makes it pure and beautiful. The rain sings a song. The song issues from its birthplace. It keeps wandering here and there, whether it is noticed or not. After fulfilling its work, its duty, the song returns with love. And now let us enter into the detailed explanation of this poem stanza-wise. The first stanza of the poem says, "And who art thou?" said I to the soft falling shower. Which, strange to tell, gave me an answer, as here translated. I am the poem of earth, said the voice of the rain. Explanation: the poem begins with the poet asking for the identity of the soft falling rain shower. Much to the surprise of the poet, the rain replies to his question, which the poet translates for his readers. The rain in its own voice, in its own way, tells the poet that it's the poem of this earth. The rain tries to say that as music or poetry gives pleasure to human beings, the rain gives happiness to the earth. The next stanza of the poem says, please listen to this very carefully. Eternal, I rise, impalpable, out of the land and the bottomless sea, upward to heaven, whence vaguely formed, altogether changed, and yet the same. Explanation: the poet says that the rain is an eternal process, but it takes different forms at different times. It rises from the land and the deep sea in the form of water vapor and goes up to the sky. There it takes an indistinct shape in the form of clouds. Although it changes in its form or shape, its core matter remains the same. Since vapor and clouds contain water, they can get transformed into the other. The third stanza of the poem says, I descend to lave the droughts, atomies, dust layers of the globe, and all that in them without me were seeds only, latent, unborn. Explanation: the raindrops pour down from above to wash away droughts and dust layers covering earth. It satisfies the thirst of the dry earth and heals everything that is degrading and is lying lifeless. The showers remove the dust particles and make earth clean and green. The rain also helps seeds to grow in plants. Now, next stanza of the poem says, "And forever by day and night, I give back life to my own origin and make pure and beautify it. For song issuing from its birthplace, after fulfillment, wandering, regged or unregged, duly with love returns." Explanation. The rain is involved in a continued process of giving life on earth by providing water to inactive seeds and making the earth more beautiful and full of greenery. Rain helps in enhancing the beauty of earth, as in the absence of water, everything turns dull or lifeless and dust accumulates everywhere. The last two lines are the poet's own words and his reflections upon the answers given by the rain. The poet observes that the life of rain is similar to that of a song. A song or poem is creativity at its best. It has the power to calm, heal, refresh, transform, and thrill. In the same way, repeated evaporation and condensation purifies rain. The entire environment gets drenched in the rain. Dust particles settle down and there is greenery everywhere, which makes the whole earth beautiful to look at. The poet therefore wants to say that both rain and music are parallel to each other, or they are same, as both have rhythm and ability to thrill. Both of them rejuvenate, recharge, recreate, refresh, and beautify life. This is the end of this poem. If you have learned something new, please like this video and also don't forget to share it with your companions. Thank you so much for watching.